play, how we want to move practice along, and we're still learning how to practice a little bit, obviously, but keep adding stuff every single day. And I do like the fact that they're working, and I've said it from the beginning, they have bought into what we've asked them to do.
And can you talk about that a little bit, what you expect, what you want on offense?
Well, if I've said it once, I've said it to them 1,000 times. I don't want to run what people call offense. We run offense. You know, our transition game is what we want to do. We want to get down the floor quick. We want to score early and often if we can, but if not, there's a flow level there that we have to have. And then we obviously have to manage the clock in the last, you know, 7-8 seconds, but we don't. Believe me, I'd be fine trying to play with a 24-second clock.
Just in general, I mean, you've switched jobs before, but you've been at Texas for so long. Just how different is this for you, and how does it kind of just change your attitude going into a season, being in a new place?
Well, it's teaching them how to practice. Like, you know, we had been 17 years where we had certain core basic drills that we knew, players knew. We just called them out. Now we're teaching them everything that we want to implement and put in. And it's fun. Like yesterday, we had a fun time in practice yesterday. I thought the guys worked hard. We threw some different things at them. But when we really started trying to compete, they went at each other.
It's just more teaching involved.
Yeah. Well, there's always teaching. Right. You don't ever not teach. But it's just a matter of every drill. You're teaching every single drill. And which, you know, in the past, a lot of that would already be done with your older players that knew it, that could teach guys some of those things before, but now it's all new to all of them.
Have you identified who your best defender outside and inside is yet?
Not really. I think that's going to be a team thing. I think that we've talked a lot about our philosophy in terms of, you know, we want to obviously get back to transition. We don't want to give up easy baskets, and we want to defend the lane. We want to. We don't want to give up wide open threes. We've worked hard at trying to chase guys off the 3-point line, and we spend a lot of time rebounding. But everything that we've talked about is team-oriented. It's about communication. It's about talking, which we don't do a very good job of right now. I've always felt like the best teams are the ones that communicate and talk. I think that can be a great, somewhat of an intimidation factor if you get guys that are just out there so locked into what they're trying to get done as a team. But we worked hard, and yesterday we spent a lot of time working with our man defense. We'll do that again today. And actually tomorrow too, before we get into maybe adding some zone work to him.
Coach, with Lamonte Turner not being able to play but being able to practice, how can he still help this team?
Well, one, we wish he could play. I mean, he would be a factor, there's no doubt about that. But what he's going to do, I think he's going to help Kevin punch more than anything, and vice versa. Those two guys really compete every single day. He's going to help Kevin, Kevin's going to help him. And I think he's done really well considering he didn't get to do a lot of the conditioning with us, and he stepped out there, and as a freshman, he's learning a lot of things that he's probably never, certainly a system that he's never been taught. But overall, he's doing well, and it's important that he improves himself too. Like, we're treating him in terms of individuals and time the way we would any guy on our team. We expect him to get better and attack this year like he was playing.
Kevin talked about changing his shot. What have you seen from him, and how has that improved his game?
A great commitment on his part. You can't do what he's done without being if you really sit down with him and talk to him about the frustrations that he went through, because it's hard. And coaches can tweak shots and do this and do that, but it still gets back to the player's got to put hours on hours in the gym and by themselves working on the most mundane things you can imagine. But he's done that, and he's a much better shooter now than he was when we got here.
So at this point, Punter's going to be the primary guy?
Uh-huh. Yeah, I would see it right now. I think he and Imani would probably, but they'll be on the floor a lot together, but if one's out, one of those two guys probably would be at the point right now.
Rick, we've asked the players about how they're adjusting to you and your staff on the floor. How are you and your staff kind of going about the process of learning which buttons to push for guys and how to coach them and how to approach each guy individually?
That's a good thing about being a coach. They got to adjust to us. But no, really, it does work both ways. I mean, but we spend a lot of time with them. I think they would tell you that we spend a lot of time with them talking about a lot of different things. And I think it's important what I think you're alluding to is how do you hit their button? You know, what's their starter button? And you can't coach them all the same. You can demand the same from all of them, but you can't coach them all the same. And some guys can take, you know, whatever. Some other guys little more sensitive, and that's important for a coaching staff that we do know how to handle each one of them.
Coach, how are the newcomers, Phillips, Alexander, Kasanga, how are those guys adjusting to college practice, college basketball, the physicality of the game?
I think from a physicality standpoint, in terms of running and all those type things, I think they're fine. I think all these guys would tell you the biggest adjustment they've all had to make is from the mental side, because we're very demanding mentally. You know, we talk about, you know, the mental being four is to one. And so we're wanting the details taken care of. We want, we say we're going to touch this line or make this number of layups. We're going to do whatever it is we have to do. And so I think for them, being on edge mentally has probably been the biggest adjustment for all of them. And I think they would tell you is that we don't let too many things slide. I mean, in terms of details, we haven't gotten great carryover from our breakdown drills to playing, but they've learned a lot, and they've got a lot to learn, but the fact is they've embraced what we've asked them to do.
You said before you can't use the word rebuild when you're talking to a senior class. How do you approach them about goals or expectations for this year when everybody's talking about a rebuild?
Well, the way I look at it is, you know, you've got to look at it like we've got two exhibition games, we got a scrimmage and then an exhibition game, and then you talk about the first game. It doesn't do any good to look down the road. I think that every day, I think you've got to improve from the first scrimmage to the exhibition game. I think you've got to improve a lot from the exhibition game to the first game, and you got to keep improving. But I will say this, some way, somehow, we're going to figure out a way every game, whatever it may be, how can we win that game? We're not going to concede any games. But our goal, I mean, if they know that we've talked about, you know, we expect to be one of those teams at the end in the NCAA tournament. And I don't think they'd want to hear anything other than that.
Yeah.
But we're not going to shy away from saying what we want. We want to be part of that tournament and have a chance like anybody else to play for the whole thing.
Coach, what do you see from Kevin at the point guard spot that you like, and how tough is it to teach a guy that's been a scorer all his life, and that's his first priority in the past, to transition to that spot?
Well, again, when you think about a point guard, we're going to play a lot of guards, so I don't know if you put it all on him to do that. I mean, there's going to be times we'll get him off the ball and let him score too, but there's nothing wrong with being a scoring point guard. You know, I mean, there's been some good ones, but he's got to know how to keep his teammates engaged, and that's what he's learning probably as much as anything, you know, how to play the point. But he's also learning a new system. But it's he had a good day. He hasn't had a bad day, and what you love about him, he's got a motor. He could go all day long, and he's gonna have to play a lot of minutes. But he's tough. I think he's mentally tough. I think that again, I think he's learning how to play that position. But he's to develop, because we're watching them do it now every day.
Jamar?
Coach, you've got some nice size, but they're all young and have virtually no experience. How have those three, Jabari, Kyle, and Ray, sort of, you know, taking the burden of being, you know, holding down the inside?
Well, you said we got nice size. That's all in the eyes of the beholder, you know. I can tell you what size is. I mean, size is five guys about 6'10". That's size. But, you know, Kyle's our tallest guy, and Ray, they're young, but again, like you would expect, they're getting better. They really are. They the pace of practice. I mean, Kyle's never been through anything like this in his life. I mean, I was kidding about it yesterday, but he keeps getting better. Ray is, again, doing some things that he's never had to do either. But overall, Jabari, I mean, we're going to have them all. I mean, someone asked me today, I was doing an interview, and we could start a different team every night. I don't really care who starts. I think it's probably more important to them than it is to us. I'm more concerned right now at who we're going to find to finish the game, because I think we're going to be in a lot of close games, and how we close them out and how we execute is going to be key. But we obviously got to get ourselves to that point. Like, we expect to be in close games, but we could. They're all going to play unless something crazy happens. I don't see a night where each one of these guys are on the floor some way, somehow.
Coach, walk-on transfer this morning. Is there a number of walk-ons you guys would like to add?
Based on my report, I don't think we're going to pick up. We already have one, obviously, but you know, I like to have 15 guys because the way we practice, you know, guys can fall quick, and you like drills where you have guys that be able to step in and help you, but I'm not sure we'll get to that this year.